Programming skills using C, lecture number 20, function subprograms. In this lecture, you will learn how to create function subprograms in C. See, function subprograms in C are very, very important. Really, without your awareness, you have been writing a function all through, and that is called the main function. But we need to make our main function very small, not more than one page. Therefore, whatever code we have there has to be converted into function subprograms. And you, during this session, you are going to learn how to write function subprograms and then incorporate them into your C code. This is what we are going to do. So we will come with that. First of all, understand what a function. We have used already functions. Try to understand the function, the syntax of a function, and then we will write a few functions. We'll take one simple example. You have used SQRT already 2-3 times. We have used SQRT, and you remember we fed in some value here, and this is called the parameter passed, and it gave you some result. Suppose you were to input 25, SQRT 25 will give you 5 as result. So therefore, a function has a function name, please remember, very important, and there is a bracket here. And then here within this bracket you are going to pass parameters, maybe one parameter, two parameters, more than two parameters, sometimes no parameters also, and then it gives you a result. So that is called the return value. Now this is an imagery of a function you are going to write. This is like a pot here. It has name SQRT. You feed in 25, you open the tap, you get 5. So there is some code is inside this pot here, which converts 25 into 5. So that is what we are going to do. We are going to name the function. We are going to write the code for this function, how to do convert this parameter into the result you want, and the return, you return the return value. So please remember this imagery all through these two sessions. We'll take two more examples. This is strlen, string length of this string which you are going to feed in here. In this case, Ashok. Ashok has got 5 letters are there, alphabets are there. Therefore, length is going to be 5. So this length will contain 5. The answer is going to be 5. Similarly, POW, power of 4 or 4 raised to 2. Therefore, what is 4 into 4 is equal to 16. Therefore, result will have 16. And this is declared in math h header, and strlen is in string h header. So these are two functions. There are many more functions we will deal with, and important that we are going to write these functions during these sessions. So try to understand, therefore, how to write function subprograms. As I said, there's a function name is there, and within brackets we give the argument list. I said one or more or even zero arguments sometimes, and it has a return value. Starting curly brackets, end curly brackets. Within that, this is like the pot here. Within this block here, we are going to write a set of statements. We are going to have sometimes local variables and then set of statements. And at the end, every function subprogram ends with return some value, what you have calculated inside this function. We'll take a concrete example. For example, function sum of numbers. This is the name of the function. I am going to input two numbers here, int A, int B. I have to say what type of function the numbers they are, and then it returns integer sum of these two numbers. And within this here, within these curly brackets, I am going to write the code to find the sum of these two numbers, which we have done earlier. It's just repetition of that, as you see here. So function sum of numbers. Int A and comma int B. These are the variables passed. These are the parameters which are passed. And this is going to be the return value. So this is the local variable int sum. So sum is equal to A plus B, sum of these two. And I say at the end, return sum. So this becomes my user defined function. Now the question is, how are we going to use this function subprogram in your main program? Before that, again, we'll come back to this imagery. So this is the pot here. This name of the pot is function subprogram, name of my function. And these are the local variable int A, int B you have declared. And what I do is, I pour in 20 here, I pour in 30. 30 here, it takes these two numbers, finds the sum of those two numbers as I have done, and then it returns sum of those two numbers here. 50 you get when you have 20 and 30, you get 50. So let us see now how we are going to use. So in your main program, in your C code, we declare prototypes here. So prototypes of function. In this case, only one function. There may be 2, 3, 4, 5, many functions. There may be many functions. So it's very, very important that you give the prototype of the function. Prototype means name of the function, the parameters passed within brackets, and the return value ending with a semicolon. Please remember the semicolon has to be there. Then we come to the main body of the function. And after that, we have the code which I've written already. That code will come here. So this is how you do the calculation to find the sum of those numbers. What it is given here. What is this function? You, in the moment, by looking at the name of the functions, you know it is going to give the sum of these two numbers. Therefore, the names of your functions should be self-explanatory as far as possible, not A, B, C, D, but they should always start with FN. Not mandatory, but we are distinguishing function name from other variable name. Therefore, we put fn here, then sum of numbers in here. Then we are going to use it. As you see here, we have got local variables in my main, int x, y, sum x. I have assigned 20 to x, 30 to y. And then I am going to just input these two variables here, values in these variables here. So they will be poured into that A and B, and then it will find the sum of those numbers. That means it will go here. This will be A, X will be, that 20 will contain here, 30 will contain here. It will find the sum of those two and return the sum 50. Therefore, when you execute this program, sum XY will contain 50, and that is going to be the answer. This is how you are going to use your function which you have written in your main program. And please remember, you have to give the code of your function here after the main program, that is after the second curly brackets. You are going to write your code for your function subprogram. So now your task: write function subprograms in C for the following. First is to convert temperature in Celsius to Fahrenheit and give it as fn C to F. C is converted to F, and your parameter is C, temperature in Celsius is passed. It is going to return the Fahrenheit value. Similarly, here you can return the area of a circle given the radius. You input radius, it has to give you the radius of the circle. So the code will come inside here. You know the formula, pi r squared, so that has to be used inside. Similarly, return the circumference of a given circle given the radius. You give the radius, it has to give me the circumference of the circle. Similarly here, float function area triangle. You give the length of three sides, it has to give you the area of the triangle. You have already done that program. You have say S is equal to A plus B plus C divided by 2. Then you say area is equal to square root of S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So those statements have to be used here, to formulae have to be used to find the area of a triangle. Similarly here, function is even. Is this number even? When you input 4, it has to return 1. If you input 3, it has to return 0. So that is what you have to do. Therefore, you have to find out. You know already how to find whether a given number is even or odd. So you take the number, you take modulus 2. If it contains 0, you return 1. If it is 1, you return 0. So please remember that. That is how you are going to write that function. So you have to write all these functions, but I am going to once again show you two of these functions. Function C to F. So I feed in C, which is a floating number, and then I calculate. As you see, this is the formula you have used. This is the local variable, float F, and return F. So this becomes the body of my function. Similarly here, function area circle. I feed in R here, the radius of the circle. I've got local variable float area, and 22, you know, pi r squared, and it calculates the area and returns the area. So this is how you are going to write all the other functions and many more functions. Now, one more thing. You have written this function C to F. I want you to use this function in your main program to list, to convert temperatures in Celsius to Fahrenheit and make a table like this. So 0, 32, 10, 50, 20, 68, etc. So you have to use this function in your main program, starting from 0 to 100 degrees centigrade for every 10. So to convert temperature in Celsius to Fahrenheit, use that function to convert and display the temperature in Celsius from 0 to 100 degrees centigrade for every 10 degrees. So that is what you have to do. So your program should give output like this. So that is what your task is. I would like you to spend some time now. Write. Now we are not going to write any more flow chart. You have to know already how to write flow chart. We are going directly into C program. And I'm going to show you how this program is written. As you see, again, we are after all this. So you have got this prototype of this function, float fn c to f and float c. And here is the code of that as we have written, and we are going to use it here. So we don't have to input anything because the program says find the convert temperatures in centigrade from 0 to 100 for every 10 degrees. So therefore I say declare the f and c, then I say while c is less than equal to 100. So I plug in the value of c first, 0, c is 0. It will find out it is going to convert that into f. Immediately I print c and f, then I go to the next c, 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 30 degrees. Every time I find the convert that temperature in Celsius to Fahrenheit, print it immediately. So this is what how you are going to use this function, function C to F, where you convert this C to Fahrenheit and use it in the main program. See how beautifully written. So you have to write your functions beautifully. And please remember, give always comment here something about the function. I have not shown you what I have written earlier here. So this is how you are supposed to write your function subprograms and use them in the main program. So this is the output of the program I have written already. So this is how you are going to get it. 0, 32, 10, 50, etc. up to 100, 212. So you have to write this function, execute that function, and then get results like this. So this is the usefulness. As you see, well, you may ask, what is the need of function? Why should I write? I could have written like earlier. As you see, you have written that function once you have written here, and you are calling it 10 times here. Same function is called 10 times. So that is one of the uses of this function. So you are modularize it and then use it many times. So please remember that. So kindly write all the other. Now you will write a function to find the cosine of an angle in degrees by summing the terms of the series till the value of the term generated becomes less than 0.0001. Now, we have done it earlier, but now you have to write a function and use it in the main program to display the cosine of angles between 0 and 180 for every 10 degrees. So this is the task you have ahead of you. I'll give you the flow chart for this. As you see, in this case, what is very simple, theta, you initialize theta to 0. You get into this loop while theta is less than equal to 180. Use the formula function cos x theta. So plug in the value of theta. You get the value of cos x. Print theta and cos x and increment the value of theta. Go on doing it. So this is what you have to do. And remember, this function cos x has to be written after the main. And it is quite interesting when you take the values from 0 to 180, it starts with plus 1, becomes 0 and minus 1. So this is going to be the output here, as you see, program to find the cosine of angles between 0 and 180. So you need to print like this, angle in degrees, cos theta, and then you have got to up to 180, as you see, starts from 1, becomes 0 when it is 90, and becomes minus 1 when it is 180. And it's a good task later to convert this into a graph as you have it here. And that will be quite interesting. So good. Wish you all the best. Thank you.